I'm really disappointed because nobody seems to like the perspective grid tool. Hello and welcome to the Vector Garden. In this video, we're going to take a look at the amazing perspective grid tool. So the reason why nobody likes it seems to be that you always have it in your way. You click at the wrong place in the tool panel and there it is. Now to get rid of it, you press Command Shift and I or Control Shift and I, and then it's gone, like so. Now, the thing I want to build in this video is a spiral staircase. Now, to start this, we're going to take the polar grid tool and make a grid first. So I'm going to reduce the number of circles and then I'm going to increase the number of pies. So there we have the initial grid for this. And then to create the stairs for the staircase, let's take the live paint bucket and I'm going to color them all in different colors, but of course you can use the same colors. So I want to be able to tell them apart. That's why I'm doing that. So let's do it this way. And I'm using the arrow keys to choose the next color for this, like so. So these are the stairs, and then let's just expand this. And in the layers panel, I'm going to inspect it. We've got a couple of groups, like so. So I'm only going to need this one. Let's take it out of here and let's just delete that one. And there we have all these shapes. So this group we need to ungroup as well, like so. That's that. And now we need to set up the perspective grid. So let's go in here again and let's just move it to the side like so. And you need to set it up initially. So you need to set it up in the way you want your perspective to be. You can even select a different kind of perspective. So you can go to a perspective that even has 3 points, like so, 3 point normal. And then you get a really sophisticated perspective. And of course you can adjust this as well, just the way you need it. So next thing, you go to the perspective selection tool, take all these, and then you're going to move it into the perspective grid. Now it's important to build the spiral staircase. We are starting from the top. So let's take it and let's select this part. Select it and just move it in here. And you see there we have the perspective, the staircase in the perspective grid. So next is we're going to start moving them. And to do this, you're going to, let's say, record the first move, which sets the distance between the steps, so how high the steps are. And of course, now you also have to select which one is the top stair. So I'm going to just start with this one. And it needs to be moved down. So in order to move it down, what you need to press is the 5 on the keyboard. So you press the 5 key and then you see you get this gray line which points down. And then you move this down, like so. Then select the next one. And the nice thing is, inside the perspective grid, we also have object transform, transform again. So this is the shortcut. And in order to move the steps now in an equal way, so they are all the same, you press D. So I'm going to press Command D, or on the Windows, you press Control D. So 2 times, and the next time I need 3, and for this one I need 4, and then this doesn't move, and it looks like I have moved it in the wrong way. So that's really bad. So if that happens to you, what you need is revert all of that and then start again. So I need now to do the first move again and then be really careful. So that's what I'm doing now. Be careful with my movement and not to move the mouse in ways that are not good for this. So this needs to be one more, like so, and like so. That's it. So the next thing we are going to do is select them all, and now we're going to copy them and paste behind. So we're going to paste behind, and then what we can do is go to edit, edit colors, and then we can make them darker. So we can also adjust the saturation, maybe make the intensity like so. We can't see that, so it's just that. And once you're done, what you're going to do is make the transform again. So Command and D, and you see the intensity is slightly different, which is nice, so we can tell front and back apart. And to have the next winding in this, so you're going to select all and then copy, paste them back again, and now it's again Command D for transform again, and move them down like so in the next step. And then you have the staircase, and you can of course continue the next winding and another winding and so on. So that's this. So this is the initial build you need for that. And now to finalize this, what you need to do is take the line segment tool, and then of course make sure that smart guides are turned on. There are smart guides. And then just connect all these corners. So connect these corners and all the corners you need. So let's make these visible. There's the other one. And let's give them a color, something bright or something that is just different than what else you have in this drawing. And of course, this is not precise, so I need to make sure they really meet the corners here. And of course, this one can be just drawn down like so. And you can continue that throughout the drawing. And I'm not going to do that. So just to show you, what you need to do now is select all of this. And then, of course, we can now hide the perspective grid. It just gets in our way visually. So let's press Command Shift and I, or Control Shift and I again. So it's now gone. And then you can take the Live Paint Bucket tool again, and then just select a color, and I'm going to the grays now. I'm going to fill this in gray so you see it, and just click inside of here and fill this so that we get these kind of shapes. So that was too much, like so. So this is how you can build the spiral staircase with the perspective grid in Illustrator. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. See you next time.